Okay.
Perfect, because I was thinking, I just take them from one.
Obviously over there, but.
Yeah.
You know, right now we have.
If you're gonna stay this afternoon, afternoon to observe or anything like that, you'll check with me. And if something changes.
All right, ready for another stack? Do you want, anyone wanna switch?
Why don't you go eat?
Put them all over there.
I'll do it. I'll do it with them.
Don't go. We'll swap in and swap out.
Could be explanations for this, right? Could have been an empty AM one.
It was in person that is minus point.
Yes, the in-person we definitely have to reach out.
Absentee is what?
It's off by two, which could be explainable that, you know, that, you know, an envelope got in here. I mean, this is 20, I'm just figuring someone gives them that. Remember last time, we were off by 20 and.
We read, because we read it twice, so.
Because they had it separated by 25s, and we read it twice. We probably just gonna need some of the recount.
We'll reread, yeah, read again, okay.
I don't know if we need to reread, I think we need to have a recount, the stacks, not necessarily recount the totals.
The people who did it, just so that.
For what?
Who did that? Oh, seven.
So five, knowing how much tables.
That means that's how long I was up, I went.
We can ask, just give it to a couple tables.
We could give actually one to each table and say, recount these stacks, yeah, okay. So let's do this one absentee, okay. So.
Oh, and is that Ward nine?
Yeah, this is Ward. Did we do this count with this one, or we're doing it again?
Oh, this is originally just.
Okay, yeah, because we're nine, so yeah, sorry. Okay, Ward nine, we've got one, five, zero. I'm sorry, I won't read zeros from now on.
No, I'll do it, just so that it's.
It's 27. 18, five. 31, 17, two. 23, 19, eight. 32, 16, two.
Two?
Yes. 22, 20, one, and seven. 25, 21, four. 25, 24, one.
Three, five, six. Here we go.
Matches three, five, six.
And then, sorry, here's this. Here you go.
And that matches three, five, six, except this is the one where it swapped the votes, which we picked up over there, so that's how we know we're down one.
One, yeah, yes, yes.
Shouldn't pick up? Well, one should be down and one should be up, so what this should tell us is that we had three, five, six here.
Is it three, five, five?
Five, uh-huh.
Okay. Three, five, five, because it's a swap of seven to nine.
Right.
Yep, and then.
So that's.
Ward.
So right, so then I think now we're only off of one here, because if we take.
I put here Ward swap seven to nine, so do you have a seven on an absentee ballot?
Oh, is that, no, so is this?
It's Ward nine.
This is actually the swap between eight and nine.
Yeah, that was nine and seven. It was seven and nine.
Seven and nine might have been a remake, this was her, this her indication.
It's the remake.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, so is seven and eight?
Seven and nine. I mean, eight and nine, sorry.
Yeah, I was like, you told me no seven.
Okay, yeah, so we swapped that one. So this, I think we could say matches.
Yeah, one, okay.
But we're still, so we're one vote off in absentee.
For?
Ward eight, because we account for the one here.
Because you had minus two, yeah, yeah, we got one, yep.
So we're just off one here.
Yep.
Could be explainable from election night. I would say that's not something we need to recount the ballots for. Definitely need to recount the ones that were off 20.
Okay. So this is, did we do absentee?
These were absentee, yep, we did absentee, confirmed that it's good.
So nine is, so the only one we're still off is
So, do you wanna then just do this, live? Or you want to?
Maybe if I've done 50 of these, but I have not.
You know what, I was looking at purple, next to purple, and it doesn't, we can't trick.
No, it is.
I know, I want, I know.
We should have different.
Yes, that's exactly what I said.
How many bees, just to be neutral, right?
I'd like the correct.
Janelle?
Or we're just thinking of different sticky, we, I've got a bunch of yellow ones here.
Whenever you're.
What color do you want?
Oh. Never mind, keep eating. Let's do a big large.
There could be some different colored ones in there, if you need them too.
Do you need the larger size?
Yeah.
Are they, are those all small?
They do.
Yeah, they do.
I don't see where else.
You have to go in the door closest to Mark's office,
Not the door.
Oh.
The grasshoppers notice?
I did a very low-key, like, when I was in my twenties, I did secure, but it was like.
We could count and I'll write on this for now, and then we can, we'll have 11 minutes to eat.
Yes, all right.
Okay, I gave you 1, 2, 3, 4, right? Yeah, okay.
Which matches the poll book.
Okay, okay.
Which, the.
And the envelope.
Yes.
Yep, perfect.
Okay, so 9 in person, I'm sorry, not 9.
I'm not.
Okay.
So I'm not a.
23.
Okay, 23.
25. 1. Okay, 24, 17, 3.
Excuse me.
28.
Had a good time to be sneezing.
16, 6.
This whole process is nothing to sneeze.
23.
You aren't kidding.
How many? 23.
Okay.
21.
Okay.
6.
Well, there's so many numbers going around, you gotta be thinking, Julie, just to get.
25.
I know.
21. 20. 9. 19. 23. 8.
My eyeballs are working now.
15.
The trees are all leaping, and that's not gonna be good for me.
20. 26. 4. 23. 25. 2. 14. 30.
30.
Yes. 6. 14, 34, 2. Sorry, there's another one. Just take that, I don't mind if I throw that there, so it's 25.
25?
Yes. 20. 5. Okay.
635.
635. Where's that cute little sheet?
Here.
Miss my Elizabeth in the screen.
Huh?
Yeah, it's always in my purse.
I need my cheaters. What are we, 9?
9, uh-huh. 635, 635. So I think we can.
We're seven, whoever starts coming in, we'll have.
Yeah, you know what, but maybe we should just make an announcement that we're gonna recount wards.
Seven in person.
Right, so I think that's what your explanation, that we're doing things a little bit differently today, is that before we add candidate totals, we want to verify ballot totals, because then we don't have that, like, oh my gosh, we're 20 off, like we did yesterday. So we've gone through them all. So we've gone through them all, and we think we have maybe a miscount in Ward 7 in person, and we're gonna ask people to recount those stacks again. We'll just give them to random people, recount the stacks, okay? But otherwise, we were able to verify and clarify the other wards.
For the most part, yep.
Yep, we're one off in one of the room wards, but that could be that we just have.
I wonder if it's that Ward 9.
Where we had the.
That is.
Couldn't find the other one.
We couldn't find the.
Couldn't find the one that was there.
No one called it, no one called it from their stack.
Right.
So, but the remake number and tally matches.
Yeah.
But, yeah, so we'll see what.
Yeah, I mean, it could be also, as we look through this, there may be, if we read the inspector statement again, there might be, sometimes we have had absentee ballot certificates sent back without a ballot in it. They've put like two ballots in one envelope.
Would that military ballot be, go to 8, or it's already included in the final?
Included in the pile, so they're there.
Because it is counted also as a remake, so you added it, okay.
Yeah, that's.
It is now time to reconvene. We're running a little late, but we're doing great. It's very important that you listen to these things. I want to thank everyone who showed up this morning who actually was not on my confirmed list. There are some people who may have said they called me, and for what I didn't return their call, probably because I had enough poll workers, or they may have emailed me and not left a phone number, so I was unable to recontact them by phone. So I do want to thank everybody who came this morning, but because I do have people arriving this afternoon who have been confirmed workers, what I need so I can swap people out appropriately, I would like, if you showed up this morning and you were not on my confirmed list, I'd like you to stand over here for now so I know who you are, so when the person at 1:30 comes, I know what table you're at and what your name is at, and it can be easily done and say so-and-so's here, it's 1:30. Thank you for your service. The other thing is, if you're new this afternoon and you haven't been a poll worker yesterday, it's important that I swear you in and you take the oath. So I also would need to identify who you are. So then you would come up to this table and let her know that you need to be sworn in, because that has to be done properly. I'm going to repeat the rules because we have a lot of new people coming and flowing. So this applies to everyone, whether they're a poll worker or an observer. There should be no water bottles on the table. We don't want any, you know, any really important documents to have accidental spills. So, and the door back there is not an exit door. It's very important that if you leave, and certainly if you need to leave to use your phone or go to the bathroom or just take a break because it's in between when you don't have any documents on your table, feel free to step outside but use this exit door, and you need to check out and check back in. No phones. Everybody was allowed to have a phone, of course, but we need to have them out of sight. If you have the need to talk, or take a break, or whatever it is, and you need to use your phone, that's okay with any of us. But please check out and go use your phone appropriately. Kathy has an announcement to make too, I believe.
Oh, which one was it? which one was it? Okay, one is, I know we have new, I think afternoon, but we still have to tally up publicly for the counts we did before lunch break. So we need those observers, it's fine, but tabulators, poll workers that worked this morning, we need you to kind of resume your seat until the final tally is called up in case we have questions to ask. We need one ward in person recounted. So if we could, are we all original tabulators sitting at the table this morning? Yes? Okay. Yeah. They might have gone in the morning, but we just, that's fine if they had to go leave in the morning. But, yeah.
Okay.
Yes. Correct. Correct. Correct.
Go ahead.
Oh, you want me?
Yeah, yeah.
I have one more. Just one more thing I want to say. I had some people who were here this morning as observers, and they were kind enough to stay. So say, if you need a poll worker, that's why anybody over here that wasn't signed up or didn't have an oath will be over here right now, and then we'll fill the seats for, I think you were an observer, and I think you can be a tally person. Yes, and I think there was one other person, so hang on, because as you can see, so stand up so I know I can put you as a tabulator.
We are both checking in as
As poll workers, okay. And I think, did you say something about poll workers?
Okay, let's just get through the first count. So if you're new this afternoon as a new tabulator poll worker, you could take a seat as a, in an observer spot for now. Let's get through the final tally of District 3, and then we will assess how many poll workers we need. Okay, thank you.
Okay. All right, so a good suggestion, I mean, I think as you said yesterday, if you were here, we're building the plane as we're flying it. We decided to add another double check of the numbers today. We took the absentee ballot certificates. Those are those number, the ballot, where the ballots arrived, absentee, whether in person or by mail, and balanced those with the absentee ballots that we pulled out. So when we were up here running numbers, we were not checking vote totals by candidate. We were strictly adding ballots. We were able to balance Ward 9, Ward 8, and Ward 7 absentee. Ward 8 and 9 absentee, we had one off. We have one identified that one of the ballots from the notes, an 8 number, Ward 8 voter was given a Ward 9 ballot, so those flipped those numbers there. Unfortunately, as we counted through Ward 7, we're 20 off. If anyone was with us here yesterday, it was just purely a stacking and totaling error. So we're going to pass one of these out to each table and ask you to create a new sheet and count it like you've never seen it before. So we'll pass them out to as many tables as we can. So again, you can ignore those ward sheets. We'll keep them, so please don't recreate those ward sheets. So, and only the poll workers that were counting this morning, you could ignore those sheets. Don't look at those sheets because we think they're wrong. Beth, don't even look at those. Okay, you're going to be doing Ward 7. Just don't look at those numbers. Right. We don't want you to, we think we're off.
Are they writing on that or are they creating?
Let's create a new sheet with you all. Please make sure your names are on the top everybody of the sheets and the audience. Tables.
They all have sheets.
Okay. Is there any table that needs tabulator sheets?
So we don't have enough tabulators we don't have enough packs, so those of you that don't have a pack, just please bear with us. But we think it's really important to recreate this and find out where that 20 is. Okay? This is all done. We are going to add the vote total by candidate, okay, by ward.
And you said these were Ward 7 in person?
Ward 7 in person. Absentee certificates away.
Yep.
We put the poll books, the poll books we'll put in that one thing, but
so I need to announce this, we're putting the absentee ballots back in there.
Yeah, we just need to label this one. I couldn't find one for certificates.
We are going to be rebagging the absentee ballots at this time.
I think
so they will get resealed.
Just a clarification, we are bagging the absentee certificates that are envelopes, not the ballots.
We need your signature when you're ready. But us do.
We're double checking, so thank you guys.
Meg?
Yes.
Oh, let me go this way.
Sure, whatever, yeah.
We put the seal on there, but we'll seal at the end together.
Yeah, I think that's good. I just thought, oh, since you got a minute, let's get that one out of the way. Throw, and then I could put those envelopes, we can move them off that table.
Bag number 006527 has now been bagged.
ballots match.
It's okay. I mean, we're on. You don't need to get their attention.
No, that's fine.
That's fine. Okay. All right. So, Ward 7, mm-hmm. 28, 17, 5, 1, 1, 19, 27, 4, 27, 20, 3.
Just 3, right?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
14, 32, 4, 17, 15, 3, 20, 25, 5, 13, 26, 11, 21, 25, 4, 22, 22, 6. Let's go see what that number was supposed
four,
to be.
437. Oh, still 437.
Number total. You don't care about those two little ones.
Pardon? Yeah, we went through the little ones. I explained that with the absentee.
Okay, so we're one down, and we still have one though. That is kind of questionable.
But this is what the hand count shows. So
okay.
That would just have one more voter than vote.
Whistle.
Okay.
That's great.
So thank you for counting. We have confirm that it is 437. We will be comparing the number to the actual poll book. We have been doing 2-3 steps, but we'll go directly to the poll book. So 438, no missing ballots. So thank you for everyone. Counting?
Yes.
And so yep. We'll start.
So now we can start adding. We're going to
go like yesterday.
Ward by ward. Mm-hmm. Yesterday we did first Preetha vote totals.
Yes.
Then we read Greg's vote totals by ward, so we can start with Ward 7.
Mm-hmm.
right? And let's,
set this over here for now.
We're just gonna consider them all together. So let's, we'll move this one's out of the way. And we can move this out of the way. There's so much paper, right? You guys all know this now.
This is, I think this is yours.
Do you guys, was this yours?
Yes.
Here, let's do it this way.
Okay, so we're gonna add totals together.
Then we can just do it this way.
Sure, I just, yeah, I think, I hope we don't knock them off.
Do you want another microphone?
No, just Linda's gonna talk.
I'm gonna be yelling out numbers.
Yes. All right, so you go ahead, Linda, do you want me to open them like that last time?
Yeah, do you wanna start here and then we'll go there and then we'll go back?
Okay. All right.
So we say pre-the 16 or whatever?
Yeah, that's what we did, uh-huh. And then we compared both sheets.
Is this awkward?
Nope.
That's okay, I'll be giving them back to you.
Yeah, 'cause we'll move from the other side then.
Okay.
Before we start, Meg, just to clarify, 'cause the steps are a little bit different, we're gonna call out the actual. We're gonna verbally confirm the absentee certificate slash envelope matches the ballot.
And we did do that.
Instead of total.
Yeah, we did do that.
But we will say it.
We're not doing the totals.
No, we're not doing totals, but we will confirm that.
Before they went to lunch, that we count, that the absentee certificates.
That confirm, and then we'll do, are we gonna do absentee and?
I'm gonna be calling out the absentee.
Actual, correct.
Ward 7.
Yeah, thank you.
So are you gonna subtotal by absentee, you mean?
Yeah, we'll do absentee first, 'cause that's the way we canvassed.
Okay, got it, sure.
So we wanna make sure we do the absentee add-up, confirm, in-person add-up, confirm. And then we'll do the total.
Yeah, and for those that, if there is a difference, it's be, the hand count is what's presiding. That's what we're using, because that was the chosen op, that the hand count's presiding, so, okay.
So these absentee ballots, Ward 7, City of Brookfield. We're gonna shout out for Pre-the first, Pre-the 16.
It's gonna be easier if I just give you the stack.
Oh, and then I go this way.
And just put them over there.
Okay.
We need to double check.
Pre-the 20. Pre-the 21. Pre-the 27. Pre-the 26.
So there's none for Pre-the?
Pre-the 0.
This was just a pack of four. Okay, so that was the total for Pre-the absentee.
That.
110.
Does that match election?
Yes. I have the same thing.
And does that match your election night results? 'Cause you guys, I don't have that sheet right now.
I don't have my sheet broken out. So you guys have to look at your cross sheet.
Yes, I have it here, yes, yep.
And you can add, we'll do the totals then after that, I would think you'll take the 110 and then we'll add it to.
Correct, correct.
Okay.
Yep.
So now we're gonna add Pre-the. Do you wanna go Pre-the in person?
Yeah, 'cause you have her, yes.
Okay, and then we'll go back to Greg the other way.
Correct, and we'll do total.
That concluded Pre-the absentee ballots, and now we are going to do Pre-the in person for Ward 7.
Okay.
Pre-the 22. Pre-the 21. Pre-the 13. Pre-the 20. Pre-the 17. Pre-the 14. Pre-the 27. Pre-the 19. Pre-the 28. And that concludes Ward 7.
181.
181.
I have 182.
From election night?
Yeah.
So what's this, minus one?
Minus one.
So if we put those two totals together, what do we have for Preetha on election night, total in election night on minus seven?
So election night's 292. Today we have 291.
Okay, all right.
And for those of you who are watching, you may be seeing us lifting up the papers. That's verification that Meg and I see the same two numbers, which were checked by the two table workers from the tabulation sheets.
So now we'll go through Greg absentee Ward 7. And do you want me to take this in that way? Okay. Yeah, so that'll be just two.
Two. Uh-huh. Greg, 2. Greg, 26. Oops. No, sorry. Erase that.
Can we start over?
Yep, let's start over.
I was reading the top number instead of.
It's good to have two eyes on here.
Okay.
Yep.
Okay. Greg, 2. Greg, 17. Greg, 18. Greg, 20. Greg, 14. Greg, 28. And that concludes the absentee ballots from Ward 7 for Greg.
99.
I have 99. And the election night, 99 matches.
Okay.
Good.
Greg, in person?
Greg, in person, Ward 7.
Uh-huh.
Greg, 28. Greg, 27. Greg, 20. Greg, 32. Greg, 15. Greg, 25. Greg, 26. Greg, 25. Greg, 22, and that concludes in person.
220.
I have 220, and on the election night, 210.
Okay.
So plus 10. Hold on.
You have 220?
Yeah.
I got 220. Polling night result is 210.
Can you look at the, this is from canvassing results. Uh-huh. So could you look at the
tape?
Where's the Waukesha one?
This is Waukesha one. Waukesha totals, I have 309 total. For
these are blank. What are you looking for?
And
oh, I don't know what happened to it.
We'll re-add one more time, and then we'll do, yeah, re-add one more time, like we did yesterday. Linda, we're going to re-add one more time. Thank you.
Do you want to add the whole block? Or are we concerned?
No,
just the
absentee matches. It's
okay.
The in-person.
Okay.
Thank you.
All right. Let's spread them out this time.
I'll stand up, too, and we'll faster.
Okay.
We are now recounting Ward 7
in person.
Mm-hmm. In person. We will start with, we will do Greg. Greg, 22.
Matches, right?
Mm-hmm. Greg, 25. Greg, 26. Greg, 25.
It's, we're looking at this total here.
Oh, so that one.
Yeah, so that matches that, and that matches that.
Oh, okay, this is put them in different spots, so this is the correct. Greg, 15. Greg, 32. Greg, 20.
Yeah, well, then that's
we're just checking the subtotals and making sure that the subtotals match, that there's not a addition error somewhere along the way. So we're being a little bit more, you know, detailed here.
Yep.
So Greg, 27.
This one's going to be a total of 52, right? So we have 8 plus 17, or 8 plus 9 plus 17, 9 plus 8 equals 17.
Yeah, okay. Mm-hmm. Greg, 17.
That concludes those.
That concludes Ward 7 for Greg.
I've got a different number. 209.
I got 209.
I got 209 that time.
And what was the election night total?
210. Election night was 210.
Okay. So we're one minus on this one. I think we must have just got off the wrong number.
Okay.
That's okay, right?
So
I think
I think what happened is at the beginning, we had that one. It was one, and I said forget it because I was reading a different number, and they might have not erased it from the.
So election night says 309.
Okay.
No, 209. Plus the
99.
Plus the 99.
Election night for Greg is 309. Preetha, 292. With the minus one for Preetha, it's 291 for hand count.
Mm-hmm.
And for minus one for Greg, it is 308.
Okay.
Okay?
All right. That was a tricky one. When it's off by 10 like that, and when they were off earlier, when it's those even numbers, we figure there's math.
Any of the teachers in the room?
Okay, so we're going to keep going on this one, and hopefully Ward 8 will be simpler and less of a challenge. Okay, Ward 8, we're going to start with absentees for Preetha, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Can I do it this way?
Or my other special notes. You want me to come on that side and do it? I was just opening for them for you.
Can I just do it this way
whatever
and give them to you?
Like. Sure.
I think that works better for me.
Okay.
So we have absentee for Preetha, Ward 8, 23. 20 for Preetha. 26 for Preetha. 12 for Preetha, 21 for Preetha, 26 for Preetha, and 2 for Preetha.
That's the end.
130. That's the end. Uh-huh.
130. And it matches the election night.
All right, so now we're going to do in person for Preetha, Ward 8.
Ward 8 in person for Preetha. 13.
No, you got to do that one too.
I know.
Oh, okay.
20, 24. I'm doing this so you can see the number same time.
Oh, I see.
21, 8, 22, 20, 22, 19, 26, 19, 17, 20, 22, and 6.
259?
259.
It matches the election night result.
And the two totals together match what was reported?
389. It matches.
Okay, good. All right. We're going to move on to Greg's in Ward 8. Okay?
This is Greg's Ward 8.
You want to do it the way you were doing it before?
Yeah, right or left-handed. Sure. It seems to go faster this way.
Sure.
So this is Greg, Ward 8, in person.
No, those are absentee.
No, absentee. Mm-hmm. Okay. Greg, Ward 8, absentee.
Yep.
2. 22. 25. 12. 17. 28. 23. That concludes Ward 8 for Greg. Absentee.
129. I have 129. And on election night is 131. We reconciled, right, with the remade? That's what we went through earlier.
This is the one where we were down one ballot. And that we did show that there was one ballot count. We were down one ballot when we did the reconciliation, and we show one ballot was counted in. A Ward 8 ballot is attributed, should be in Ward 9. But wait, that doesn't make a difference. No, we did show we were off
by one.
Yep. Yeah.
So we have a ballot missing or one more vote?
I think at this point it doesn't matter whether ballots were fed through twice on election night or not counted on election night, since we're using the hand count, that's what we're using.
Yep, we will, hold on 1 second. So what do you have, Chris, when you add up those two?
I'm 29 and 130. 259.
No. That's fine.
Done that.
129.
Okay, so we still have to do.
I'm making notes here.
Can
yep.
We do absentee.
Mm-hmm.
We're not on 8 yet. We still
correct.
Or 9 yet. We're still finishing 8. Correct. We have to finish 8 in person for
yep.
For Greg.
Oh.
Okay.
Right.
Yeah. So.
Mm-hmm.
Put them to my left. And we'll
that's okay.
So we're doing 8 in person for Greg.
Yes. 8 in person for Greg.
We are now doing 8 in person for Greg for Ward 8. Greg 7. 21, 22, 28, here's a repeat, 28.
Two different ones.
Yes. 19, 24, 20, 24, 23, 8, 22, 23, 29. That concludes Ward 8 for Greg.
298.
298.
So we add that to 129, absentee hand recount is 427. Election night was 429, so it'll be minus 2. So hand count total for Greg for Ward 8 is 427.
Okay. So
We will now be doing Ward 9 absentee for Paretha first.
I don't think I was going to sorry about that.
I'm looking at the numbers. Paretha, 25. Again, Paretha, 25. 22. 32. 23. 31. 27. And 1.
One eight six. Election night is 185. So we'll add 1 to 186 for absentee for Paretha.
Election night total was.
Correction.
Election night was. What do you
in
have?
In person on election.
No, we did absentee.
We just okay, did
so absentee election night is 185. Mm-hmm. Hand count shows one more, so we're gonna add 1.
Yeah.
So hand count number of Paretha absentee ward 9 is 186.
Yes.
Sorry,
yeah.
That's where I went to law school.
Sorry.
Okay. Yeah.
Well, you check
right.
me, so that's fine.
So good
second set of years.
So we're going to.
All right.
And those did balance. So.
Yep. In person.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, it did.
Yep, we're doing in person. Uh huh.
We are doing now ward 9, in person, Paretha.
But that's okay. They've got a couple. They stick
couple.
Together. Uh-huh. So there we go.
Pull that. That was a blank tabulation sheet there. So I lifted it up and saw one done and one not. But that was
we
just
got 2 now.
That's why we pulled one. It's blank. Okay. So I will repeat. Ward 9, in person, Paretha, 25. 14, 23.
Ooh, don't go too fast, you missed one here.
Ooh.
Thanks.
The 23, okay?
Yep. Yeah, just another pile.
20. I just grabbed 2 at once instead of 1. 20. 19. 21, 23, 28, 24, 23, and that concludes Ward 9 for Paretha.
275.
275.
It matches election night. So we'll add 186 with the hand recount. It gives us 461. So we're going to add plus 1 to the total to Paretha Ward 9. So 461 total.
We are now going to do Ward 9 absentee for Greg. Greg, 5, 18, 17, 19, 16, 20, 21, 24, that's it. Mm-hmm. That's the end of the absentee Ward 9 for Greg.
140.
140, and it matches election night number.
We are going to do, sorry, we are going to do in person for Greg, Ward 9, 25. 17, 16, 21, 25, 20, 23, 15, 26, 25, 30, 34, 20. That concludes Ward 9.
Two nine seven.
And it matches election night, so 437 stays the same.
All right. So we're gonna move on to that other ward now, right? I don't know if you wanted to do any of your swearing or flipping.
Yeah, right now I will be putting in the afternoon crew, and some people will be switching out and leaving at this time. And then after that, I guess.
Okay, yep.
Or do you want me to open up the...
Well, you can start putting... You guys can
or you can put that away.
Okay.
If there's anybody who only signed up for morning, leave.
So whoever is leaving that's not going to stay through next 2 hours, I suggest if you're a tabulator, if you're planning to leave, now is your time, because if we start counting in next 10 minutes, you have to stay till it's done and till hear the final result. That's gonna be a good 2 hours. So if you're leaving or you're confirmed, please leave now. And if you are new poll workers that has been sworn in, you could come over here and Linda will designate a seat while we wrap up and open the new set of votes. Thank you. So meanwhile, the tabulators that are sitting at the designated poll worker seat are all sworn in, right? Because I know there are some new people. Okay, perfect.
I
No, it's not me, but I know I'm used to it. Yeah, that I was not a big fan of.
They might help diving in.
Yeah.
They might help diving in.
Here, I'll take certificates.
What is that? This is Ward one.
Second Ward.
I need green here. Green.
I'm gonna start opening and calling out.
Okay.
I'm gonna. Is that it? Is that all?
Is it, I guess this
is that all one is. Of what? Do they name it? Dang it.
No.
Here, 2 of 4, 3 of 4, 1 of 4.
2, 3, 1 of 2. Yeah, it all depends on how they do math, guys. And this one, I had to reopen. They needed an envelope. The original's in here, so you can pack that to 2 of 2. And then this is my signature and my associate's
signature. I'll call out what we're opening. Let me know if you can't hear me. I'm just going to walk on and do it. Okay? Do you need me to wait? I'm gonna do miscellaneous. We have to read everything, right? Okay. Okay, I'm just gonna give you names. I mean numbers, right? Okay, I'm opening the bag 4073. 500 11038.
Oh, not 4073.
No, it's weird bag. Yes. Okay. 7802. I know. It's not numerical, same system. 7802. Okay. Yep. 47535. 4074 4753 4753 2 4753 4 7 5 3 4 3 4 7 3 4
No, the other one had a different.
Oh, yeah, the other one had a totally different number on it.
The rest of these were all 5-digit bank.
Yes. We might be counting the rest of these by ourselves. That one was the, no, the other one. One of the other ones, I think. Yeah. Yep.
Paired up, that's fine. Okay, just a reminder, observers, we don't have that many, but please raise your hand. No conversation. I mean, sorry, no, not now. raise your hand if you have questions. There's no conversation with the tabulators. Only conversation that should be happening is among tabulators to kind of confirm, and no touching the ballots by the observers. And please, all the water on the floor. We don't want any ballots get wet. And then phones should be on you, away from the table. And if you, except for the tabulators, while we're counting, if you need to, observers can come and go anytime you need to and take the phone, but there's no phone usage. And if you, someone needs to go to bathroom and there's a ballot on the table, all the counting stops until the other tabulator comes back. And if both of you have to go to bathroom at the same time, just raise your hand and one of us will come over and stand over the ballots. Let us know any questions. Thank you.
Okay, so we're going to...
You will do this because you're...
Okay. We're going to start passing out the ballots. Remember, we're going to try to do absentees in the absentee tables. These should be absentee. When they're, just make sure we're separate because they're tuned.
I didn't separate absentees.
These aren't.
Oh, in your ward?
These are
all in person.
Those are all in person?
These are all in person. Those are absentees.
What is this, in person?
These are in person.
Yeah, okay, I don't want to mix it. These are absentee.
No, that's probably a little bit of both. So we got both and both. So we'll have to do, let's just pass out like half of these, or like a, how much of it? So we have one,
this
two.
All absentee.
I would divide these into two, so one table, two tables, four tables, yep. Five, six, seven, eight, nine. We should be able to. Chris, can you split that in half?
I need to switch out.
Is this in person?
In person, yeah.
You just can go to puppy. One table, three tables.
Two. Yeah, I think we could do two because we can have them sort and count like we did before.
You want two tables?
Two tables, yeah. I would say she did two of that, so 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then we can do 10, 11, 12. So we got 12 tables, right?
They get this too?
Yep, that's an in-person one. Okay. Yeah, because that's a ballot. Two tables, perhaps. Yeah, you know what? Because we don't have. Oh, there's somebody back there. Okay, yeah. For some of you that are looking at the ballots in this district, they do have a split where they also vote. You're going to see the back of one of the ballots, the purple ballots, I believe it says 12 part. Look at, flip that one around. Does that one say 12 part on the back? Yep, so 12, the parts mean is that part of the district votes for Elmbrook. Part of it might vote for, I think it's Waukesha Schools. It shouldn't matter to you and the whole count, but if you have one on the back that they didn't pull out that says something than other than Elmbrook Schools, pull it out. You'll know because there won't be an Elmbrook School candidate on the race, okay? Absentees, make sure you're noting on your statement, that your tabulation statement, whether you're doing absentees or originals. Okay? Okay. All right. So this looks like
yes, they're all open. Who are these for? Regular and irregular.
I think those are absentee. Oh, no,
it's
absentee. Yeah, I think
that's a big one. These are Waukesha. It must be says not, whatever.
No, they just, that's yeah. How they did the writing.
Okay.
This might be, that's because he's in an honorable
program. None of the above, that's probably what it meant.
Oh, good, you're so smart. OTA.
This was in here, right?
Yeah.
No.
So put that was in that was in that.
Okay. And what about
that.
That one? Okay.
No. We have to open it.
Do you keep both back?
Yeah.
Yeah. Put them one in another. Those are